Hare Krishna, we are in the 8th canto, 12th chapter and 22nd verse. This is Lord Shiva at this moment being captivated by Mohini Murti. Tam viksha deva iti kanduka lilayesha vidasputa smita vishita kataksha mushtaha stri parekshana prati samikshana vihivalatma Natma namanti kaumam saganam shaveda. While Lord Shiva observed the beautiful woman playing with the ball, she sometimes glanced at him and slightly smiled in bashfulness. As he looked at the beautiful woman and she watched him, he forgot both himself and Uma, his most beautiful wife, as well as associates nearby. So let us understand the trick of Maya. How this Maya is. I'll just expand on that. In the Chatushloki Bhagavata, the whole Bhagavata is summarized in 4 shlokas. Krishna says, everything comes out of me in the first shloka. And the last shloka says, if you think there is something which is not connected to me, the second shloka says that, if you think there is something which is not connected to me, know it to be the influence of my Maya. So the Maya operation starts when we are able to when it disconnects us, any object we are watching, it disconnects to the Lord. And then it depends on our addiction also. Say liquor. Now Prabhupada says, when you look at those who are drunkard, even while drinking, they can at least remember this taste is Krishna. It doesn't that we start drinking and then remember that. Even at that stage, you can start remembering Krishna is trying to come out. But the point is that the 4 regulatory principles are designed in such a way that definitely they break the connection between us and Krishna. They make us forget Krishna. We should not do the regulatory principles. When you break a regulatory principles, certainly you forget Krishna. Just like I'm taking liquor. And I start enjoying the liquor. I forgot connection between liquor and Krishna. It is Krishna's creation, not yours. You cannot enjoy it. Now, as my addiction is more my enjoying tendency there. Suppose I am not addicted to liquor. The moment I look at liquor, it doesn't influence my heart. My heart is very peaceful. And I connected to Krishna. It belongs to Krishna. Everything belongs to Krishna. So in that way, when you look at this world, for all the regulatory principles you can understand, it is because of my addiction, I'm disconnecting it from the Lord more and more. Okay? Illusion only operates when you're disconnecting anything from the Lord. Is that fine now? Therefore, Prabhupada says now, when you see a beautiful girl, you think she can be one more beautiful gopi for Krishna. You're connecting it to the Lord. You're not affected. That is the only way you can deal with Mohini Murti. Because I discussed that Mohini Murti's body is not made of blood and stool. That will not work. How do you deal? You can think that this beautiful form, let it be another gopi for Krishna. Okay? Here it is anyway not gopi for Krishna, it's Krishna himself. Then the Maya will not operate on you. Okay? If there is even slightest a tendency of enjoyment, then we will be victimized. And therefore the famous shloka is coming here. Apumsa Sriya Mituni Bhavam Eta Tayor Mito Hride Granti Ahu Ata Griya Setra Sutapta Vite Janasi Mohe Amahamaviti. So this world operates on this illusion. All of us are victimized in that way. And as we chant Hare Krishna and heart is purified, the addictions are reduced, and they go away. In a process of reducing the addiction, Prabhupada recommends the example of the tiger. The tiger example has 2 fold. Tiger example is only that person who wants to nullify his attraction, addiction to this world. Once his disciples in America asked Srila Prabhupada, see, we are following you on your orders, but our mind is disturbed. So Prabhupada said, it's very dangerous. You can fall down from this position. If your Rajoguna can any day lead to Tamoguna. Rajoguna means mind is disturbed. Sattvaguna means mind is pure. Tamoguna means mind is so disturbed, you do sinful activity. That's my simple analysis. So if the mind is disturbed, Prabhupada, any day you will fall down. So they said, what we should do then? On your order we are following, but then, you know, mind is very disturbed. So Prabhupada says, you should understand the example of the tiger. So how a tiger is caught in the forest? We catch a tiger in the forest by some trap. And after the tiger is caught, we do not enter the cage. We wait for some time. We starve the tiger for some time. After we starve the tiger for some time, we enter the cage with a whip. Because the moment the tiger sees you, oh, you are the one who put me here. Huh? He will attack, he is a king. He will jump to eat you up. And then what will happen? You will take your whip and beat him because he is very weak now. He doesn't have much strength. You starved him for a few days, he will have himself like you starve for 2 days. Then can you attack somebody? You have no energy, isn't it? You have no capacity. It's the same way tiger is starved, he has no capacity now to attack that man. But he tries, easily he is whipped. He can withstand the attack. Then what happens? The tiger is controlled. Then you can take charge of the tiger. You can make him your pet or whatever. Give him food, something. He gets subdued by you. Okay? So similarly, presently, by taking some wrong steps, by taking some wrong contemplation, whenever I look at certain things in this world, I'm not able to connect it to Krishna. Take it, na? So what you should do now? Keep the object away for some time. That's how the de-addiction camp works. Suppose you are addicted to liquor. And you go to de-addiction camp, they apply this tiger analogy only. They will not going to give you liquor. No liquor really available for a few days. Any addiction, if you are weak-minded, then there is no end. You will take whole life to come out of addiction. But if you are determined, just stop it. 10-15 days, you don't take it. What will happen? The force of the addiction will reduce. Correct? Pampering, you can pamper whole life, the stupid mind. Correct? It will never allow you to even follow ABCD. Correct? This is the mind we have. So you keep this out of sight, out of mind. So what happens? The liquor will not be available for 15-20 days. Then what happens? The addiction will gradually reduce. Hana? If you put a fire on ghee, it will never go. You have to stop putting fire. So once, say 15-20 days, 1 month, there is no liquor given. Then after that, it is possible. Suppose the addiction is very strong. And you don't follow the tiger analogy. Suppose I am a drunkard and I decide, or say I am a smoker and I decide I will not smoke from today, from tomorrow. What will happen? The mind will say, come. It will force you to smoke 10 times rather. Correct? So therefore, we have to surrender. And that is called surrender. Surrender means now the acharya is more stronger than my mind. Surrender doesn't mean something sentimental, paying some dandavat. That is external. It is good. It is good, but that is not real surrender. There are 6 principles of surrender given by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What are the 6 principles? First principle, anything favorable for Krishna consciousness, we accept. Second principle, anything unfavorable, we reject. Take it? Third principle, accept Krishna as my guide. Fourth principle, accept Krishna as my master. Rakshishati Vishwasa, he is my master, he will protect me. Fifth principle, always meek and humble in front of the Lord. And sixth principle, have no desire other than desire of the Lord. So we should see, this is called Sharanagati. You know Sharanagati, there are a lot of people following Sharanagati Marga, but this is Sharana. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made it so systematic. In fact, many devotees have done analysis of this 6 principles based on thinking, feeling and willing. And they got beautiful results. Big charts I have seen devotees have made. It's very deep, the 6 principles, which actually make us totally surrender to Krishna. Correct? Totally surrendered in your thinking, feeling and willing when you accept the 6 principles. Once you follow these principles, what will happen? In the beginning, maybe some inconvenience. Okay? Therefore, you have to take somebody's help to keep, or you have to take a determined vow. Therefore, Prabhupada says, unless you are determined, yesterday also I said that, you cannot follow regulative principles. You cannot follow. Unless you are determined. Even though you are chanting 69, you will not be able to follow. You have to use the power. Chanting Krishna Nama gives you the power. Now you can follow any regulated principles you want. You have to exercise that power. You cannot say, I am chanting Hare Krishna 16 rounds, I cannot follow regular. This is joke. You are making joke of the power of the holy name. Prabhupada says 16 rounds is so powerful, no power in the earth can make you follow. He is giving a dosage, no? He is giving a medicine. He says, if you do this, no power in the world can make you fall down. There is no way you can give an excuse after chanting Hare Krishna. 16 rounds you are chanting and I say, I cannot come out of it. It is stupid. It's very stupid. You are not using the power. You got the power. Yeah, you can just use the power now. You got the power now. You can cut off anything now. But if you don't want to use the power, you can fall down still. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, associate Kala Krishna Dasa fell down, Prabhupada comments there, you have to be determined. He was not determined. You know, there was some attraction, gypsy woman, but his associate, he is personally serving Lord Chaitanya. Enough power is there to give up all the attraction, but he was not using the power. You get the power. So this is where it's situated. So what happens generally is that the Maya will play tricks with us. I have to do this. I have to guide this person. In fact, most of the brahmacharis slip in this way. I have to guide this girl. Nobody to take care of her. But you wait, just wait a moment. When you're looking at that girl, and for a girl, it will be boy. It's a corresponding. Are you able to connect her to Krishna? In case you are feeling lusty, means disconnection already started. If you see the whole world connected to Krishna, then you can enter even just like Prabhupada entered nudie club in America and preached and brought some people to his ashram. Once his gypsy, most of the initial followers of Prabhupada are hippies. So once there is an instance that took Prabhupada to a nudie place, because in the beginning Prabhupada was collecting from the street, like brooming from the road. no, who will come to him? He is living in a very poor place in America. He was just brooming, collecting. But he collected 4,000 in that way. And he transformed them, created a miracle, made sannyasis out of them, and made them preach all around the world. And they were preaching, they made devotees. So when Prabhupada was taken to that place, he went, "Will you go? You should not go. Because you are not able to connect that person to the Lord. You cannot. Therefore, Brahmachari is not allowed to see a naked woman. Because he cannot connect it to the Lord. He starts enjoying tendency. Correct? To the degree I am addicted. If I am not addicted, doesn't happen. Just like liquor. I am not addicted. You give me a glass of liquor, even to the lips, I have no interest to me. It doesn't make any fun. Correct? Because I can connect it to the Lord. Because if I am addicted, the enjoying tendency comes when liquor is put on my lips, correct? Immediate disconnection happens. Then the Maya starts. Maya's work is to disconnect an object from the Lord. Okay? So this is very, very careful. So Prabhupada says, we convert matter to spirit based on our capacity. Don't do more than that. Nobody is asking you to do that. Everybody stays in the bounds of his ashram. And there is no midway. Either you are brahmachari, you are grihastha, vanaprastha, sannyas. You cannot say, I am brahmachari thinking of becoming grihastha, or I am grihastha thinking, there is no midway. Yeah, brahmachari means brahmachari rule, grihastha means grihastha rule. I find funny sometimes, people say, now Prabhuji, I am brahmachari now, but I am thinking of becoming grihastha, so I can think about girls. No, there is no midway. You follow either brahmachari ashram, or when you are brahmachari, follow brahmachari ashram. When you are grihastha, follow grihastha ashram. There is no midway like that. So therefore, things are very clean and systematic. Now, Lord Shiva, in this position, he is actually playing the role being dragged by Yogamaya. He is being enchanted by Yogamaya. Correct? Why did Krishna do that? So that we get a lesson. It is not that to give Lord Shiva a lesson. Lord Shiva was anyway very happy when he was defeated by Lord Vishnu's Yogamaya, not Mahamaya. He's so happy at the end. Because he's his master. Suppose you have physical fight with somebody who is your master. He's your teaching fighting. And you get defeated. You are happy. He's really powerful. Isn't it? Suppose you have a competition with somebody who's superior to you. You get defeated. You don't mind it. When somebody inferior to you defeats, you mind it. So Lord Shiva is very happy, being defeated Lord Vishnu. Because Lord Vishnu, he has already accepted as his master. Like Jambavan, when he was defeated by Lord Krishna, he didn't mind it. Rather, he handed over his daughter to him, Jambavati, for marriage. Huh? Jambavati? Chalo. So he handed over. He had no problem. He's very happy. So Lord Shiva, but why this instance has happened, there is a lesson for us. Lesson is, don't watch this. Therefore, generally Prabhupada says, the men are very wicked, generally. Therefore, they should not watch the woman sports. You know, this they created women's playing with ball. They should not sit and watch that. Nowadays, girls are having basketball, men sit there. No, don't do that. Because men have a lot of enjoying. Girls are not so bad. That's why in ISKCON also, don't feel bad, the girls. The rule I'll tell you. In ISKCON rule is, men can take class, girls cannot take class. Even though many times girls are as advanced, maybe more advanced than boys. The reason is this. The boys, when they look at girl, they will, if a girl is taking class, boys will start enjoying immediately. They will not be hearing class. They now got an excuse to stare at that girl. Girls don't do that. They don't do that. They're not so bad in this feature. Therefore, ISKCON in India at least. In America, it is difficult because equality is too strong. Society will have a revolt. But in India, Bureau made a rule. Women don't take class. Even a leading, they take class for girls. Therefore, yeah, there are Prabhupada disciple girls are there. They're taking class for girls in India. Then many big temples, there will be 500 ladies itself attending class. Rather, they are more in number always. So they take class for girls, ladies. But they generally avoid to take class for men because men are crooked. They'll not be hearing the class. Then how do you take class when atmosphere is so degraded? That better don't take class. And even leading kirtan, you know. Generally, it is said, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in Jagannath Puri, so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started running. One lady was singing some beautiful Gita Govinda and or something, a similar song. I don't remember exactly. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was then always in bhava. He started running to embrace the person, forgetting the voice of the woman's voice. So immediately somebody, Sarudhama, somebody embraced the Lord and held him. Don't run. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, you saved me, you know, I would have run. So proper writes in the purport there. Be careful, don't hear woman. Because the voice is, by Lord's way arrangement, the voice is very sweet. Men's voice are not so sweet. Women's voice are made so sweet. So that it attracts. So then they asked Prabhupada, then you are Govinda. It's a woman singing. And Prabhupada made a rule. Every temple you have to put up, no? The Prabhupada said, no, that's okay. That's chorus. Because not one, many people singing together. He made an exception sometime. It is said, every rule is an exception when that was played to Srila Prabhupada. It was very, very intense. Prabhupada immediately started crying when he heard the Govindam. It was such a call. You seen that? You new people, you put it up, they come stunned. It's not the music. That's why people should not get lost. Music is not very important. What is more important in that is the bhav. Intense. Anna? They made her sing many times. Wherever she goes to any temple, now she is no more. What is the name who sang that? Anybody knows Sridhar? Yamuna Devidasi. Wherever, even Vrindavan at the last year on the planet, she was in Vrindavan, they made her sing that. Very intense that prayer is. Govinda Madhi Purushantama Bhajami. You meditate on Brahma sitting on a lotus and Brahma is praying intensely. I worship Krishna only because of Chintamani and whatever reasons. Okay? So this, therefore, Prabhupada said generally men create the sports when the women play and they want, actually they enjoy. Women playing tennis, very popular, we should not watch. Anyway, devotees should not watch all this at all. Even for people who are, still crawling, you know, actually we should avoid women playing sports. Totally we should avoid because you will enjoy. You'll not be looking at tennis, you're looking at that girl and you'll destroy your spiritual life, correct? So these are all the principles actually. This is Lord Shiva. Who are you? Lord Shiva got victimized when a girl is playing a ball, correct? And what he was looking at? Not her playing ball, at her dress and her features. That's what you will do and you will fall down from spiritual life. So we have to be very careful. ध्यायते विषया पुंसा संगस्ते शुभजायते संगा संजायते कामा कामा क्रोध विजायते क्रोधाद भवति सम्मोहा सम्मोहा स्मृति विभ्रमा स्मृति भ्रमशाद बुद्धिनाश बुद्धिनाशात् प्रणश्यति. सो ट्रू लॉर्ड शिवा इज अफेक्टेड बाय योगमाया बट प्रिंसिपल इज सिमिलर. नो योगमाया ऑल्सो इज अ विशियस साइकिल. ठीक है बट एज अ लेसन यू कैन टेक एज महामाया वेर इट स्टार्टेड क्यूरियोसिटी. Just a cure. A Lord came as a beautiful woman. What is the need for you to see? Why you want to see? Why you want to see? This stupid curiosity makes you fall down. Mind will trick you for some stupid curiosity. A latest movie has come, latest actress has come. Just want to see how does she look. People are saying she's very famous. Why you want to look? What's the purpose? I just want to see. Once nothing happened to me. Nothing. Ajamila also I tell every time. Ajamila was so pure, his heart was full of Satyaguna because he was showing wonderful qualities. Qualities are only shown in Satyaguna. You don't show qualities in Rajaguna and Tamaguna. Rajaguna, you are disturbed, Tamaguna, you go mad. Hana? The qualities, if somebody is showing good person, means he is in Satyaguna, mode of goodness. So if all the qualities of Ajamila have listed, which are all wonderful, he's so kind, he's so soft, he's so gentle, he's so respectful, he's worshipping the Lord with faith, everything is given list. But he is not a pure devotee now. You can say he is Nishtha. Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Bhajanakriya, Anarthi Nivritti, Nishtha. He is pure Brahmana. Kanishtha Vaishnava. He is like that. And then, what happens? He goes to the forest, he hears the sound of a man embracing woman. And the giggling sound. He knows what's going on. He is already a young married person. He thought, nothing will happen to me. Nothing will happen to me. For 1 minute, I'll just watch what's happening. Just 1 minute. Nothing will happen to me. In 1 minute, his whole life was destroyed. Dhyayate vishaya pumsa sangaste shubhajayate sangha sanjayate kama kama krut. Therefore, do not play with fire. Spiritual life means do not play with fire. Do not play. You should be very, 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 very careful. Very, very careful. So Lord Shiva watching the Mohini Murti playing with the ball, and the next description we can't even read. The wind comes and blows her dress away and she is naked now playing with the ball. Lord Shiva runs now, lost. He pranashati. Actually Mahamaya doesn't operate, but for us it would have gone. Stage, final stages, pranashati falls down. His wife is sitting next to him with his presence of his beautiful Umaya. Durga is an extremely beautiful personality. There is no need for him to run there, correct? Leaving his wife. Forget wife. At least in front of your followers, you will not do that, no? One thing you will not do in front of your wife, because then wife is not going to see your face. Correct? You have seen that. There was some instance, you know, not to. Where it was? Yeah, this Clinton. Clinton was with his wife, you know, who lost the election. Correct? And they were showing the video, the body language. And he saw the new president Trump. And Trump's wife is young. She looks much more beautiful than it. And the Blinken, Clinton is known for being a, you know, that's how he had a problem. He had to resign. And now, the first time the president and his wife, new president, came on the stage, they show Bill Clinton. He was staring. They show the whole, his eye movement. He was staring at Trump's wife. And they showed the face of his Clinton's wife. You know, she was so upset, so angry. You know, she knew what's happening. This man again doing same thing. It doesn't, habits don't change. You saw that? The people showed him that his behavior. The point is this, in front of wife, you'll not like to do that because definitely now she's not going to speak you for days. True? True or not? Okay? You understand? Just imagine in front of wife, Shiva is doing this. Now taking a lesson. How much the Maya can make fool out of you. Yes.